The radio access network mobility procedures for the radio access network procedures for mobility there. So now in this, on the continuation of that, we'll see about for inter radio access technology handover. There are two events that is going to occur, that is B1 and B2, that is going to trigger the measurement report there. So here your B1 is nothing but when the neighboring cell radio link is going to be radio link on different radio access technology becomes greater than the absolute threshold, that is LTE even B1. So LTE even B1 is going to be triggered when the neighboring inter-system cell becomes better than a threshold. So the event is triggered when the following condition is true, that is the measurement of the neighboring cell plus the neighboring frequency minus your hysteresis width is greater than the threshold level, then you are going to have the event B1 to trigger. That is, the handover is going to happen. Otherwise, the triggering of the event is going to be subsequently cancelled when the following condition is true. That is, measurement of the neighboring cell plus your neighboring cell frequency plus your hysteresis width is less than the threshold. Next is your event B2. So here your event B2 is when the serving cell radio link quality becomes less than the absolute threshold and the neighbor cell radio link quality on a different radio access technology becomes greater than another threshold. In that case, it is going to be your B2 event there. So here your event B2 is the LTE event B2 is going to be triggered when the serving cell becomes worse than the threshold 1 and while a neighboring inter-system cell becomes better than the threshold 2. The event is triggered when both the following conditions are true. That is, measurement of the serving node plus your hysteresis is going to be less than the threshold 1 and measurement of the neighboring cell plus your neighboring frequency minus hysteresis is greater than the threshold 2. Your event B2 will occur. That is, your handover will occur there. Otherwise, your handover will get cancelled. That is, measurement of the serving cell minus your hysteresis is greater than the threshold 1 or measurement of the neighboring cell plus the frequency. Your neighboring cell frequency plus hysteresis is going to be less than the threshold 2. So, the time to trigger. So, when the triggering is going to happen is the amount of time when each of these events is going to measure is going to satisfy the measurement report. So, when the measurement report is going to be satisfied, the amount of time in each of these events is going to happen. So, a time to trigger parameter is going to determine, is going to be used to prevent the user equipment from ping pong between the E node Bs. A measurement report is going to be triggered when there is a significant change in the radio link quality. So, a paging procedure. So, a paging procedure is nothing but your initiation. So, whether a call is coming or not, an initiation request has been done by the user equipment or not, that is all going to be checked there. So, it is a connection control function of the RRC protocol there. So, in RRC ideal state, the user equipment is going to monitor the paging channel for the incoming calls. So, in RRC ideal and your RRC connected stage, your paging message is going to be used to inform the user equipment about the system information change, about the earthquake and the tsunami warning system notification, etc. So here in this case, the paging message will do the modification there. Next is, if there is going to be a change of system information that is going to occur at specific radio frames, then also a paging message will be sent to the user equipment. So here we are going to have your modification period. So your modification period is, if the system information is going to be same within this, the system information will be same within this period, and the user equipment will acquire the system information at the beginning of the modification period there. So paging frame. So paging frame is nothing but a radio frame in which the EEUTRON can page the user equipment. So one page frame consists of one or more multiple subframes there. Each subframe is nothing but a paging occasion. So your user equipment will use your discontinuous transmission in the ideal mode and monitor one paging occasion per discontinuous reception cycle and switch off its receiver during other paging occasion to save the power. Your paging information is going to be carried by the physical downlink shared channel though. Thank you.
நீ ஒன்று தான்.